So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to another session of PIB 247. In today's session guys, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And ab NABARD ki notification aa chuki hai, aap sabko pata hoga. So you all know ki ab in session ki jo importance hai wo kitni zyada badh gayi hai. Now ab aapke man mein sabke sawal aa raha hoga that for how much period hame current affairs cover karna chahiye. तो मैं हमेशा कहता हूँ कि मिनिमम सिक्स मंथ्स इज रिक्वायर्ड बिफोर द एग्जाम, बट इफ यू आर डन विद द सिक्स मंथ्स देन यू शुड गो फॉर एट और टेन मंथ्स आल्सो, बिकॉज दीज डेज वी कैन सी दैट एग्जाम के जो पैटर्न्स हैं वो काफ़ी ज़्यादा चेंज होते जा रहे हैं. आरबीआई ने जो लास्ट टाइम का जो फेज वन था उसमें काफ़ी डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन पूछे थे और पिछले 10-12 महीनों तक वो चले गए थे. सो फॉर द नबार्ड ऑल्सो आई वुड रिकमेंड कि मिनिमम 8 मंथ्स यू शुड डू बिफोर द एग्जाम. सो आप अपनी प्रिपरेशंस को जो है गेयरअप कर दो अच्छे से, फेज वन फेज टू दोनों एक साथ करो, बिकॉज फेज वन के बाद फेज टू में उतना ज़्यादा टाइम नहीं होता है. एंड नेक्स्ट वीक से वील बी स्टार्टिंग गवर्नमेंट स्कीम सेशन का जो सीरीज था वो भी स्टार्ट होगा फॉर द नबार्ड ओनली. एंड इन नबार्ड वी विल डू ओनली स्कीम्स फ्रॉम दोज मिनिस्ट्रीज विच आर रेलिवेंट फॉर नबार्ड ओनली. फॉर आर बी आई वी विल डू लेटर, जब आर बी आई का एग्जाम आने वाला होगा तो हम उसके लिए भी कर लेंगे, बट अभी हम केवल नबार्ड से रिलेटेड जो स्कीम्स होंगी उसके ऊपर फोकस करेंगे. एंड ऑफकोर्स जो स्कीम्स नबार्ड से रिलेटेड है तो आरबीआई से रिलेटेड तो है ही, बिकॉज आरबीआई में कोई मिनिस्ट्री स्पेसिफिक स्कीम तो पूछी जाती नहीं है, वो तो कहीं से भी पूछ लेते हैं. बट नबार्ड में ऐसा है कि कुछ मिनिस्ट्रीज हैं जैसे जहाँ से स्पेशली स्कीम्स से क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है, लाइक मिनिस्टर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर हो गया, फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री है, इसके अलावा अपना मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स, फूड एंड पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है. तो ये कुछ मिनिस्ट्रीज हैं जिनसे कि क्वेश्चन ज्यादा पूछे जाते हैं, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट, पंचायती राज हो गया, तो इन मिनिस्ट्रीज पर हम फोकस करेंगे. ओके, सो नबार्ड की प्रिपरेशन तैयार कर दो एंड आज का सेशन शुरू करते हैं. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द डेली सेशंस एंड ऑल्सो रिगार्डिंग द कोर्सेज. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ये जो इंडिया स्मार्ट सिटीज अवार्ड 2020 था, दैट वाज अनाउंस्ड इन द मंथ ऑफ जून, बट इट वाज बाय मिस्टेक मिस्ड बाय मी. सो नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस न्यूज. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग इंडिया स्मार्ट सिटीज अवार्ड्स 2020 एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट हियर. सो इंडिया स्मार्ट सिटीज अवार्ड 2020 हैज बीन अनाउंस्ड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. सो द न्यूज इज वॉट? The Union Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, which is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. Hardeep Singh Puri is the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs. So this ministry has announced the India Smart City Awards 2020 under the Smart Cities Mission. Ek Smart City Mission hum sab jante hain. Smart Cities Mission is what? Basically to develop the cities. Okay, 100 smart cities ko develop kiya jayega. Yehi uska objective tha and it was launched in the year 2015. And under that 100 smart cities are being developed. And development का मतलब यहाँ पे क्या है? Digital infrastructure, economic infrastructure, हर तरीके का physical infrastructure, so social infrastructure. तो हर तरीके का infrastructure will be developed in these smart cities. Okay. And for this award, a contest was organized by the under the smart cities mission by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. And there were some parameters जिसके ऊपर इन अवार्ड्स को डिसाइड किया गया. देयर वर सम पैरामीटर्स ऑन व्हिच दीज अवार्ड्स आर बीइंग अनाउंस्ड, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल सोशल एस्पेक्ट्स, गवर्नेंस, कल्चर, अर्बन एनवायरनमेंट, सैनिटेशन, इकोनॉमी, बिल्ट एनवायरनमेंट, वाटर, अर्बन मोबिलिटी. सो बेसिकली ऑल द बेसिक पैरामीटर्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू अ सिटी आर कंसिडर्ड वाइल अनाउंसिंग दीज अवार्ड्स. Now talking about the additional parameters. So keeping in mind the COVID-19 situation, they have added two additional parameters. Number one is the sustainable business model of integrated command and control centers and innovation in COVID-19 management. So these are the two additional parameters that were added this year. This year, ye do additional parameters the that were added for announcing these awards. And uske alawa jo basic parameters the they were already there. Now let's talk about the winners. Who are the winners? That's very important. So number one day it's Uttar Pradesh. If you talk about all among all the states and UTs, so Uttar Pradesh was at number one. Number two paid was Madhya Pradesh, followed by Tamil Nadu, which was at number three. Okay, so Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, and then Tamil Nadu. Now talking about the ओवरऑल डेवलपमेंट में अगर हम सिटीज की बात करते हैं, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट जस्ट द सिटीज, सो इंदौर एंड सूरत, इंदौर एंड सूरत वन द अवार्ड जॉइंटली फॉर देयर ओवरऑल डेवलपमेंट. इंदौर और सूरत को अवार्ड मिला है जॉइंटली फॉर देयर ओवरऑल डेवलपमेंट. एंड वी ऑल नो इंदौर इज ऑल्सो द क्लीनेस्ट सिटी ऑफ आर कंट्री. एंड अहमदाबाद वन द अवार्ड फॉर स्मार्ट सिटीज लीडरशिप अवार्ड. वॉट इज द कैटेगरी? स्मार्ट सिटीज लीडरशिप अवार्ड में अहमदाबाद वॉज नंबर वन. देन चंडीगढ़ वन द अवार्ड इन द बेस्ट यूनियन टेरिटरी कैटेगरी. द बेस्ट यूटी अमंग ऑल द यूटीज इन आर कंट्री इज द चंडीगढ़ रिगार्डिंग द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ स्मार्ट सिटीज. एंड इंदौर ऑल्सो वन मोर अवार्ड विच इज इनोवेटिव आइडिया अवार्ड. ओके, इनोवेटिव आइडिया अवार्ड भी इंदौर को मिला है. So guys, this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement or statements. Uttar Pradesh emerged as the top state for overall development. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Followed by Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Number one pe Uttar Pradesh hai, number two pe Madhya Pradesh, number three pe Tamil Nadu. Indore and Jabalpur won the first award jointly for their overall development. Yes, this is also correct. This is also correct. Chandigarh bagged the award for union territories. Yes, this is also correct. One second. No, I was confused there. Indore and Surat won this. Yes, Indore and Surat. Indore और Surat को जो है वो joint award मिला था. Chandigarh ने union territory में जीता था. Yes, an additional parameter of sustainable business model for COVID-19 management is added. No, COVID-19 management का innovation add हुआ था. ठीक है, innovation for COVID-19 management was the additional parameter और दूसरा parameter अलग था. So we have second and third statement which are incorrect here. Second and fourth. Yes, so option B, only 2 and 4 would be the correct answer because we have to identify the incorrect statement. Let me check it once again because confusion ho gaya tha thoda sa. Uttar Pradesh emerged at the top state. Yes, Indore and Surat won the award, first award jointly for their overall development. So this is incorrect. Second is incorrect. Chandigarh bagged the award for union territories. Yes. An additional parameter of sustainable business model for COVID-19 management was not added. So this was also incorrect. So second and fourth are incorrect. Option B, guys, would be the correct answer. I hope this news is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number two. The centrally sponsored scheme for development of infrastructure facilities for judiciary. So this is a scheme under which infrastructure of courts are being developed. And this is under implementation since 1993-94. 1993-94, and it is a centrally sponsored scheme, which means the funding is shared between the center and the states, jahan pe bhi wo court ka infrastructure ban raha hai, where the infrastructure is being developed. All right, and now this is not only for the Supreme Courts or the High Courts, it is for the overall judiciary infrastructure. All right, for the lower courts also, for the Sessions Court also. So the centrally sponsored scheme for development of infrastructure facilities for judiciary has been approved for continuation by the central government. The question is, since which year the scheme is being implemented? So as I told you, this scheme is under implementation since the financial year 94, which means the correct answer should be option A, 93-94, the financial year 94. Now let's move ahead. What is the news? So I think the news is clear. So now this scheme has been extended for further 5 years. अगले 5 सालों के लिए इसको extend कर दिया गया है. Starting from 1st April 2021 to 31st March 2026. Now what is the total outlay? अब extend कर दोगे, लेकिन पैसा भी तो देना पड़ेगा. बिना पैसे के कैसे काम चलेगा? Extension करने से क्या होगा? पैसा भी तो देना पड़ेगा कि नहीं? So 9,000 crore is the total outlay, and out of this 9,000 crores, 5,357 crores will be provided by the central government. Including rupees 50 crores for the Gram Nyayalaya scheme. There is one more scheme, Gram Nyayalaya, jiski baat karenge hum, don't worry. So this 5,357 crores includes this 50 crores for the Gram Nyayalaya scheme also. Remember this. And the total outlay is how much? Rupees 9,000 crore. Agar is scheme mein se question aaya, to outlay ka hi aayega. Ya to fir kab se wo implemented hai, tab usse aayega. Theek hai, isse zyada nahi aa sakta. Now isme benefits kya honge? These are not important for the exam, let me tell you first. These are not important for the exam. Obviously, आपसे ये नहीं पूछा जाएगा कि कितने residential unit बनाए जाएंगे, कितने court बनाए जाएंगे, कितने toilets बनाए जाएंगे. It will not be asked in the exam. These are just for the basic understanding that what are they doing under this expansion. So they will construct 3,800 court halls in 4,000 residential units. Then they will construct 1,450 lawyer halls, 1450 toilet complexes and 3800 digital computer rooms. So obviously these things are not being asked in the exam and will also not be asked. So don't remember all these, don't mug up these facts. These are just for the basic understanding that, okay, if they are expanding a scheme, then what are they doing under that, right? So the correct answer is what, option A, 93-94. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Which of the following is not one of the objectives of setting up and operating an international trade finance services platform? So we all know we have an authority, International Financial Services Center Authority, IFSCA, which is headquartered in Gandhinagar. Kahan pe? Gandhinagar mein hai. Now the question is, you have to tell me who is the chairperson of IFSCA. Very, very easy question I'm asking. Bahut easy question hai. Who is the chairperson of IFSCA? Write down in the comments. And headquartered in Gandhinagar. So let's talk about the news. What is the news? International Financial Services Centers Authority, which is located in Gandhinagar, has released a framework. They have released a framework for what? For setting up and operating an international trade finance services platform, ITFS. International Trade Finance Services Platform. Iske naam se pata chal raha hai kya hai ye? International Trade Finance Services Platform, which means financial services will be provided to those persons who are doing trading internationally, which means the exporters and the importers will be provided with the financial services through this new platform, which is known as International Trade Finance Services Platform. And for this, a framework has been launched by IFSCA. Now, this is to provide trade financial services at the International Financial Services Center, as I told you. And these are some more objectives of this framework. Like, for example, it will enable exporters and importers to avail various type of trade finance facilities. As I told you, jo exporters or importers hain, unko trade finance facilities di jayengi through this framework. And at the competitive terms for their international trade transaction. This will also help in their ability to convert their trade receivables into liquid funds. Jo unke paas trade receivables hain, usko liquid funds mein convert karne mein ye madad karega. And also to obtain short term funding may be ye help karega. All right, so these are some more objectives. And now what was the question? Which of the following is not one of the objectives? All right, so to provide trade finance services at International Financial Services Center, yes, this is one of the objectives, absolutely correct. To enable exporters and importers to avail various types of trade finance facilities, this is also correct, option B. To convert exporters and importers trade receivables into liquid funds, this is also correct. And to help them in obtaining short funds. So all the four are the objectives. Between option E, none of the above would be the correct answer, because in the question they are asking about the objective, which is not one of the objective. Okay, so option E, none of the above would be the correct answer. And now let's talk about question number 4. Where will NTPC बहुत न्यूज में आता है भाई. NTPC बहुत, मतलब इस देश में अगर कोई काम कर रहा है तो NTPC है, और कोई काम नहीं कर रहा, बाकी तो सब बस बैठे. Where will NTPC Renewable Energy Limited set up country's first green hydrogen mobility project? देश का पहला green hydrogen mobility project कहाँ पे सेटअप किया जाएगा? First of all, what is the meaning of green hydrogen? Green hydrogen क्या होता है? हरे कलर का दिखता है क्या? नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है. Green hydrogen is not that जो हरे कलर से दिखे. Green hydrogen is that which is produced by the electrolysis through the renewable energy. Okay, मतलब electrolysis में जब हम renewable energy methods का इस्तेमाल करके hydrogen को बनाते हैं, तो उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? Green hydrogen. Okay, so green hydrogen क्या हो गया का मतलब ये है, electrolysis जब हम करेंगे और with the help of renewable energy methods, तो that is known as green hydrogen. So the question is, where they are setting up it? So this will be set up in Ladakh. Option B, Ladakh would be the correct answer. You can see here, project in Ladakh, and it will help in Ladakh developing a carbon free economy based on renewable sources and green hydrogen. Okay, so Ladakh here is the correct answer, Ladakh, option B. And talking about NTPC, so remember, it was established in the year 1975. It works under the Ministry of Power. Ministry of Power is headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. R.K. Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Ara, which is of course in Bihar. And who is the CMD of NTPC? It's Mr. Gurdeep Singh. Gurdeep Singh is the CMD of NTPC Limited, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. सो अब आ जाओ क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 पे. विच कंट्री बिकम्स द फर्स्ट कंट्री इन आर इमीडिएट नेबरहुड टू एक्सेप्ट मोबाइल बेस्ड पेमेंट्स थ्रू द भीम ऐप. भीम ऐप कहाँ पे लॉन्च हुआ है बेसिकली क्वेश्चन ये है, घुमा के पूछा हुआ है, लेकिन सिंपल क्वेश्चन ये है कि भीम ऐप कौन सी पड़ोस की देश में अभी पैदा हुआ जाके दोबारा से. सो दैट पड़ोस की कंट्री इज नन ऑफ दीज, श्रीलंका नेपाल नो. सो द करेक्ट आंसर हियर शुड बी नन ऑफ दीज. तो कौन सी कंट्री है, दैट कंट्री इज भूटान. भूटान में भीम ऐप लॉन्च हुआ है. नाउ हियर यू डोंट हैव टू गेट कंफ्यूज्ड, लेट मी टेल यू दिस. भीम ऐप एट द मर्चेंट लोकेशंस, अगर आपसे पूछा जाए कि भीम ऐप एट द मर्चेंट लोकेशंस सबसे पहले कौन से देश में लॉन्च हुआ था, द आंसर वुड बी सिंगापुर. द आंसर वुड बी व्हाट, सिंगापुर. द क्वेश्चन वाज वेयर इन विच कंट्री वाज द इन विच कंट्री भीम यूपीआई भीम ऐप was for the very first time launched for the at the merchant location. Merchant location पे कहाँ पे launch हुआ था, तो the answer would be Singapore. And number 2 would be Bhutan. Okay, but if the question is in which country UPI, Bhim UPI has been launched, so then the answer would be Bhutan. Clear? मैं फिर से repeat कर देता हूँ. सिंगापुर में क्या हुआ था, भीम ऐप लॉन्च हुआ था बट यूपीआई उनका खुद का था. अब भूटान में क्या हुआ है, वो हमारा ही यूपीआई जो इंटरफेस है उसको इस्तेमाल करें. Okay, so I hope the confusion is clear. And now let's talk about what is the news. The Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, along with her counterpart of Bhutan, has jointly launched Bhim UPI in Bhutan. This is the news, and it was launched by NPCI International Payments Limited, which is an arm of NPCI, National Payment Corporation of India का ये एक arm है. In partnership with the Royal Monetary Authority of Bhutan, Bhutan की जो Royal Monetary Authority है उसके साथ partnership करके this app has been launched. And with this launch, remember, Bhutan became the first country to adopt UPI standards for its QR deployment. So as I told you, it is the first country to accept our UPI standards. Okay? While Bhim app was for the very first time launched in Singapore. Its QR deployment and the first country in our immediate neighborhood to accept mobile-based payment through the Bhim app, because Singapore is not the neighbor country. Rupee cards are also accepted in Bhutan when last year Modi ji visited, in 2019. When Modi ji visited Bhutan, then rupee cards were launched in Bhutan. So currently rupee cards are also activated in Bhutan, and it is also the second country after Singapore to have Bhim UPI acceptance at the merchant location. So as I told you, Singapore ke baad dusra nation and number one pe in the terms of accepting the UPI standards of our country. All right. Bhim stands for Bharat Interface for Money, the very basic things. I don't think that I have to tell you this. Bharat Interface for Money, it is a payment app which was developed by NPCI and it is in under operations in December 2016. All right, so here the correct answer is option E, none of this, because the country where this app has been launched is Bhutan. All right, so that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. सो मिलते हैं मंडे के सेशन में. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.